Hi guys, this is a UC sales shop, and today for a review we have a veteran Sherman. Now it's January 2021, and this is one of the lastest product from the lastest batch. So all these small problems was in the first batches are fixed here in this wheel. So January, a lot of snow outdoors, so I cannot test this wheel outdoor. So I tested it indoor in the parking places. We have some huge parking places, so 10 kilometers was done. I was tested it in fast riding, fast accelerating, fast braking, and so on. Just overall performance to ride across all these parkings and to feel this wheel. I understand this is not so big experience, but overall my experience are huge, and I can understand what this wheel is about. Just right about the 10 kilometers will be, I think, will be more than enough. Some small points maybe about the overall ergonomics, how it feels when you're riding 40 kilometers per day or 50 kilometers. Yes, of course, it's hard to say, but first impressions and first feelings. Okay, let's start from the beginning, from the overall ergonomics and the look of this wheel. So what I like in this wheel and what I dislike in this wheel. So first of all, it is look. It looks like a tank, and the name of American US United States of America tank Sherman. This brutal heavy look are here, and this design are great. I think yes, great. Why not? Because it is not looking like our all products, and it is nice. We're going their own way. So for the wheel which we'll be using in the heavy conditions and riding a lot and so on, so this look is, I think, it's not bad. Of course, it is only a subjective opinion. Such a solutions like the separate lights, you can just change it easily, and for example the front light, you can adjust the angle of the light, and the front light are beam are very powerful and great. It is more powerful than the Bigode company have their beams in their latest products. Very great beam, and you can adjust just level. And another point, it have the strobes, red light strobes here, and when you're riding, you can strobe it. About the strobes, the idea is, I don't know how the police will react to this, because in Europe, in Lithuania, we are restricted to using the red strobes and the blue strobes. So I don't know how we will act and look at this when you will ride in the dark, and these two strobes, red strobes, are pushing like the policeman cars and so on. So I don't know that, and I don't know how the police will act in your country, but just keep it in mind. Check it before you ride in the city with strobes, wherever. So the lights are connecting here with a mini jack like you're using in your phone, and you're using in your earphone. So solution not so great, because it is completely not water resistant. Water may come on common side, and we have here a voltage. So anyway, shortcut can come here from these two ports for sure if you will riding on wet conditions. About the pads, I like the pads. These pads not so huge, not so big, but this is a power pads, and they are so comfortable. I was thinking, because we are selling and we are manufacture our own power pads, and I was thinking I will put it just for the review, just to feel all this the product in the original shape, what the manufacturer can provide to you. This is just for the testing purpose, but I was thinking I will test it, will put it off, and will put mine pads, and will continue my ride, continue to test the more performance, because as all we know, for the such a heavy and the powerful wheels, we need to give more power, and usually you are not just enough to go only with your weight to push it to see the maximum performance this wheel can provide. And the same is for the braking. So the power pads, it's needed for sure if you ride in hard conditions and for testing. But with my pleasure, and I was so excited, but I like it and I stay on this wheel and I feel what in the ergonomics and the leg shape all okay, and these small parts are just perfect for this wheel. For sure, yes, in the market we have a better solution just for better riding, for the extreme riders, for the maximum power, maximum comfort and so on. But from the box I can say that these pads are really great. And I don't know, I had some information that some dealers are not providing with pads in the box. I don't know why, because when we ordered it, the wheel, the pads was inside the box, and we do not pay as a dealer, do not pay for these pads extra money for the dealer. So pads are great, and I think yes, so, but this pads is only for the Sherman because of the shape. These pads are made from the inside, were made the shape for this, all this plastic, so you cannot use it in another wheel. It will not fit just in the place, I think. So in the box, yes, the powerful 5 amps charger are here, and it is a most powerful charger you can get with in the box with a wheel in the market. So even the Bigode Monster Pro and EAX and EAXN using same 3 amps charger here. So this is 5 amps and really great. Two ports outside, 5-pin aviator ports for the charging, and I think you can just push two 5 amps chargers and put maximum 10 amps here to this wheel to charge it. But I do not really recommend this because I was opening this wheel and I saw these connectors, I think XT30 connectors, very small one and small wires. So when you push 100 volts and 10 amps, so it will get hot. So maybe, in my opinion, if you want power charger, fast charger, using till 8 amps, I think, because it may burn inside, just the wires may burn. This is just my opinion. Of course, we do not test it, but I know when I was charging the Monster Pro with my supercharger 8 amps, and the wires, all these wires to the wheel get hot. These wires get hot from the 8 amps, so 10 amps and wires inside may be damaged in the time, so if you will charge it quite often. So, and the ports, as you can see here, these ports are for sure are ugly, and these covers here, rubber cover, always from the when you're going and you have this all these vibrations, and so they are always open it, and when I stop riding and see these ports are open it, and for sure these small covers not fit exactly and not cover from the real dust and real water may come inside here in the ports and may make some problems for you, like a shortcut and so on. Mudguard is not in the box and you need to buy it separately, about the 30 euros we have here, and the seat, original seat, also not in the box too, extra money, about 60 euros, and this seat is good but not great. I don't like it so much because when you put it here, you see, when if you will sit in the this place in the back place, so the seat always opens like that. And for you, when you sit it and it opens, you made like this, and this is not so great. Of course, you can make here some type of Velcro and put it just to be more stable, to fit more great. But I saw many users who are using the veteran Sherman, they made their own seats, they put some types of handles here using this RAM construction and putting here better seats. And I understand, because when I tried to ride it, I wanted to sit in the middle somewhere, because when you sit on the back and the wheels just want to stop, so you need to push it in front, push with your hands or with all your body. So this type of sitting on the wheel are not so comfortable. So, and this seat is for sure very small. So, not so great, but you can use it and not so bad. About the tail light, I don't like the design of a tail light. Yes, it is beaming quite strong and you very informative and all around see your wheel. But like the design, like the look of this one are for me are not so great. The quality of the material, it is very cheap, like the China stuff, you know. I think for the, such a product, because the front light, the lamp are looking really great, but the back lamp is no for me, because front light, as you can see, you can adjust the angle and it's metal, so all great. Here about the handle, and the handle in the middle, very good position and very strong metal material, and many manufacturers like the Bigode and the Kingsong may see this product here from the veteran Sherman, and may see how strong these metals are made here, and this plastic handle and the metal, the strips from the sides are very, very strong, and when you put it, the height is very good for you to handle it. The overall handle is in the middle, so it is really greatly balanced, and you can easily operate with this wheel with no problem here. About the pedals now, so the pedals are quite big in the length, so this was quite good experience for me, and I don't think what if you're a usual rider, you need to do something here fastly, because it was comfortable. Not so big in the wide, and I think if I will ride more miles per day, for example 50, 60, 70 miles per day, so it will, I think I will miss this part of pedals which are in the wide. So the next part about the pedals, so as you can see, if you have, for example, if you want to ride, you cannot take just with your hands to open these pads. It's completely made like you cannot take it. It's very hard with one finger, but if you are using gloves, it is impossible for you to grab it. Why they made this? They made it, for that reason, but here they put less metal and made this angle to give you a more opportunity for turning, for the clearance on the turning. So that's why we made the pedals like that. This is a good point from one reason, but the bad point was that you cannot open it easily every time you want to open it with hand. But the good point, you can just shake the wheel in one side or another side, and both pedals will be open for you for sure. Good one point, but the bad one point is what usually these pedals are always opening in your car. When we put this wheel, you grab this wheel, and always these pedals are just not fitting strongly, and they always are opening, and I would try to do same today in my car. I was taking the wheel, the pedals was opening and was cutting the seat and so on. So you see, the solution sometimes we need just to make another solution, because if we are producing these wheels half a year ago, and I think we know this problem about these pedals are not comfortable to open, or not comfortable to take this wheel because they're open too often. So this is about the pedals. Not bad at all, and overall, as I was staying on this wheel, it was good. And I was accelerating, I was braking, and this one was a really good part. About this one, handles, and this the metal are really very tiny here, and every impact you will damage this one metal parts, and you will damage it, and it will go inside for sure. It is very, very, very light metal, and this metal is rusty, so if you will damage your paint, so the rusty will come outside quite soon. And overall, how these handles are made and how we're fixing here. So it is, but here this is not a fixing point. It is just that these plastics are taking this metal, not to turning like that. But where here is no any rubber inserts, no additional fixing, no nothing here. And for sure, if a wheel will go hardly on the asphalt or somewhere, you will have a bigger drop, you will damage this plastic and you will cut this plastic, so you will need to change all these panels. So maybe for the manufacturer will be better solution to make these separate parts here and made it from the metals, so separate from the overall body. You don't need to change all this body, even if this metal part will be broke, you just unscrew it, take it out, screw it a new one here, and it is good. The idea is that these handles are fixing only on this one few wood screw. So this one wood screw are going inside the handle, and this is only one fixing point for all of this, and second one from another side, and that's it. So here, and when you take this wheel and when you shake like that, you feel like it is going like that. So I understand, only one fixing point is not really great. I think we need to do something here to fix it additionally, but I understand why we don't do that, because if you will fix here the handle, so if you have a stronger impact, this one fixing port in the plastic may damage your inner shell, and you will need to you will be needed to repair the inner shell here. So anyway, I was opening this wheel, and for sure I see what is not so many difference in the idea and design and overall how all this stuff are done. Not so big difference with Bigodi Gotway company, and we all know what these workers was working before in the Bigodi, but after that we come to and made own business and made own product like Veteran Sherman. So overall, like all this wiring, all this battery, and overall inside architecture, like all this placement are done, it's very close to the Bigodi here by the quality. And I will explain why, because when I opened these covers here, and you have all the screws here outside, so you don't need to find the screws, you just unscrew it. No Loctite was found in these screws, but this is not a big problem. Another problem is when you open this part, side panel, you understand that the battery are not safe for the wet condition, for the rain and waterproofing at all, because even for the Bigodi products we have rubber insert across all the covers. Here we don't have nothing, just one plastic goes to another plastic and that's it. And here the situation is even worse, because in this side the plastics not even goes on the cover like that, you know, when the one part are going to the another. So this one here solution in the upper side are more like for the King Song 16X, where we just one plastics are going to another like that, and that's it, and no real protection for the dust and so on, and no way water will come inside. This is one point. The second one point, of course, from the one part, from the one side, we have the wires from the motor, and we have the hole, but from another side we don't have nothing, but as these two parts are identical, so we have a hole here too, and this hole just going to the motor and it is opened. Why we don't close this hole in the factory, I don't know, but anyway, as I said, and all water and dust and so on will go to this hole too. Bad point, sad point, but I see it is very close to the Bigodi as we making such a products here. Another point is about the waterproof. Yes, we see with this huge tire here, and we have a lot of snow outside, and I want to run to test it, but I understand what I cannot do that, because it will be not safe. Yes, I tried to ride in the parking place. I find a little bit snow where on my own risk, not so, not, it was just right 10 meters maybe. And after that I push all this snow from the wheel and then continue my journey. So for sure it was not long riding on the high speed, it was very low speed just to see the performance of this tire. But as I said, wheel looks brutal, like a tank, and the tire brutal, and everybody for sure want to ride in the such condition now and to have fun in the snow. But this wheel is not waterproof like all our wheels, and some solutions are even worse than all our manufacturer have. And one of these solutions, as I was said previously in my reviews about the problem with a controller, with a main board, when you have your heat sink, your radiator from another side, and this heat sink are going to the another part of a wheel, to the inner shell, and you will have a hole there, and only one rubber insert are separate your controller and your batteries from the wheel and the water, mud, salt, and so on. So here in the Veteran Sherman, we don't have this solution. We don't have this type of a heat sink coming to the wheel. But we have another not so great solution, and I was a little bit disappointed about that. What we have here, a hole that is from the wheel and the water, mud, salt, and so on. So here in the Veteran Sherman, we don't have this solution. We don't have this type of a heat sink coming to the wheel. But we have another not so great solution, and I was a little bit disappointed about that. What we have here, a hole, when you see your front light, we have here a hole from another side, we have mirror hole here, and all this wind are going inside when you're running fast and so on, going inside and going from this side, from the back side. So, and here we have this heat sink and radiator are coming all across this surface here. So idea, you get here air and all air going from this side. So, and for sure, of course, the main board are on this heat sink. So idea is, when you're going on the wet, all this rain and all this water are coming here directly inside this one hole here and this one hole here. It coming inside, maybe somewhere going in all these plastic rooms you have this here inside the wheel, but this water will definitely will come inside. So guys, as I was filming the review about the safety, and I was talking about the Sherman, and I said that from the front side and from the back side we have two holes for the ventilation, for the cooling system. So some feedbacks from Sherman users was provided to me, but this is what I'm saying is not completely true, and here it is fully waterproof in this place. So I just opened this one up cover to show you, and I put here the lighter, my phone lighter, and just to show you where we have the problems. So the first one, as you can see, the lights are going directly here, and here we have the holes when the water can come from this side. Yes, we can make the isolation here, we can just put here some type of a silicone and so on, but anyway, as I said from the box, and I was saying about the possibility to using from the box, so as you can see here, we clearly see where the water can come from the front part. So another point is, as you can see here, this hole, this room for the plastic for the four sides, 1, 2, 3, and 4 place, this is the room inside the shell where the water can come, and you see this about 3 millimeters gap here, room, between the plastic and the radiator. You can see here clearly the light are coming, and I will try to show you more maybe. You can see on my finger, you can see clearly see, but this is not waterproofed. So the idea is, as I was said, that the water can come inside the body. It will not directly come just to the controller like a splash. I don't think about that, but idea is that the water can come inside the body here in these places and all these four places. And after you will, for example, put the wheel on the side, so the water will come back here and come back directly to your main board and to your resistors, and this way will make a shortcut for all system, and the system will burn. So this was my idea and my opinion about the Sherman from the box. Of course, we can take out this main board and to see and ensure where we have this all these rooms, and we can make the all this around with a silicone and so on. So I think this will definitely help to prevent. But I was speaking only about the how it is from the box, from the factory. So it is not waterproof. So it is not safe for sure. And there's so many issues where main controller was burned and the people cannot understand why it was burned. So I think this is maybe one of the reason when you're using it in wet. So all this water just going here from this hole. So this is first point. Another point is about this one screen here, and from the first generation, all users said that this screen is not safe because it is very tiny plastic screen, and it is on the some type of glue here, and it is not completely water resistant. The water are coming just directly from these corners and going inside. So yes, even I saw some solution of covers, transparent covers here making, but you need to understand that I was take out this cover here, and it is only on the four screws here. So when you take it out, you understand that you don't have nothing here, nothing resisting here. So only the plastics, as I said, going one plastic, going on another plastic, no rubber inserts, no some waterproof solution at all. And we have here only four screws, 1, 2, 3. So I even can see now what is not going just exactly ideal, you know, parallel to another plastic, because when you screw it from the only four sides, the plastic get its tightness and plastics go like that, you know, and you for sure you have here not 100% plastic till plastic and no rubber insert, and for sure you will get here water too from all this cover here inside your wheel, and if you will go on wet and rain and so on, so the water will come inside and you get your wheel burned here. So my idea will be to make for sure maybe two or one rubber inserts and make more screws here. Maybe 8 will be nice, something like that. So screw it in the more places you made is tighten to another part of the shell to make all this protection to your wheel. So they do not do that. I don't know that. So I really do not understand why we're making such a, in my opinion, great products in the Sherman. It is great wheel, very good wheel, dynamic wheel, but why they do not pay attention to all these details to make it waterproof, to make it not burn it after you're using it in wet condition and so on. So this is very important part. I don't understand why we're doing such a solutions. I don't know. Maybe we are not have so many times to think about all this stuff, and we want just to make it to the production as soon as possible. But the engineers, they need to think about it. We need to think what this wheel will be using in some hard condition, and maybe the water will come. We need to put the water here to split the water and to see what will happen and to make it more safe for our riders. Maybe the second generation of the Shermans will be better here. But now we have clear situation. It is not waterproof proof, and it is dangerous to ride in the water, in the wet snow, and so on. So it will be only on your risk. About the tire, so the tire is interesting just for that reason, but this is very great tire for going off-road, going muddy, sand, going snow, just perfect. I was trying to go snow a little bit and it is handles just 100%. It is best tire for such wheel, I think, in the market. Very good grip, perfect grip, but as a good grip in the such off-road conditions, so as bad it is on the just on the good road, on the good asphalt and so on, because all these knobs here, this knobby tire, when you're going to the corner, these knobs are just swimming from one side to another side. You push it, the wheel, you feel like these knobs are going, and all this wheel are feels unstable on these knobs. You're going on the corner, the wheel shakes like that, you're pushing it, it is going like that more. When you're going from the corners, this knobby begin to act in the another side, so the wheel like going like that, so it is not so comfortable to ride fast and making fast cornering for sure. And for sure it is a lot of noise when you're riding with this tire. So all this problem is with the knobbies, because you cannot find the super universal tire to be good every in everyday usage in the good roads and the bad roads. So you need to understand that for the good road you need to go with a street tire, for the off-road you can use such a tire. So now, just in the ideal situation, what this wheel would be waterproof, it and you could go in outside to ride in snow and get your fun. So this is the best solution you can find on the market, and it will be definitely so fun to ride with this tire. But for me, for the summer, I will not put that tire for sure, because usually I'm riding the normal roads and I like riding light gravel roads, off-roading, light off-roading, like the forest, small roads and so on. So I don't need such a performance tire here. So I definitely recommend to put some type of a tire we have here on the that Bigodi EX or Bigodi EXN, same dimension tire, 14 inch on 2.75. So same dimension, you can use this tire, or maybe you can find like the Michelin on Dunlop the motorcycle tire and put it here for the better handling on the on-road and on the fast speed. Because even I was trying to push to stop hard extremely from the 42 kilometers per hour, and I feel because of all these knobbies the wheel starts to wobbling. So I think in the extra braking in the high speed more than the 70 kilometers you may have your real problems here with wobbling just because of this tire. So you can just need to keep it in mind, it is not for the speed runs for sure. And overall the wheel is feeling, I feel that the wheel is quite good balanced, but this tire are making all this stuff really bad for riding and get your fun. Because when I was riding with a Monster Pro, when I put the Michelin tire, it was an hour game. And for sure, compare the Monster Pro and the Sherman, these two wheels are not comparable at all. The Monster Pro are still the Monster Pro, separate type, separate class of the wheels, and this one is only the one wheel on the market with such performance and such experience you can give, and such fun you can give, the wheel can give to you. So it is different product. The Sherman is like the EXN, like the X, like the RS, something like that. So the overall same dimension, same wheel, a little bit more weight, bigger battery, but overall like it acts on the roads, it is more like the lightweight wheel, not like the heavy one wheel. So I still will be tested the EXN and will compare it for with Sherman soon. Will be my next review. But for the Sherman, so when I was start riding, and for sure you are all waiting for my verdict and my opinion about the possibilities of this wheel. So when I was start riding, I was quietly surprised it have a great acceleration. For a heavy wheel, 35 kilos, really great acceleration. It is greater than the Monster Pro for sure. It is greater than the suspension one model EAX with over almost the same weight, only 4 kilos difference was here. So, but this is acts like the small one wheel. It acts like the RS, like the MSP, and so on. Really fast, you know, I feel I push with the legs to the power parts, I push with my body, 100 kilos my weight, I push it and I feel like the wheel start accelerates, and it is quite easily starts accelerate, so this feeling is really great. So guys, my SD card was for a bad day, it was out of a storage, so today I will continue and I wanted to speak about the performance now. And one of the important part what I was seeing this wheel, so the pedals, when you're riding, the pedals are going, not just staying on every corner or on acceleration, on braking, staying as on our wheels, but the pedals are going forward for you if you're going and pushing it fast forward. So the pedals are going forward deep. It is quite, it is not like it is going very fast, but it is quite slow, but you feel that the wheel are going to the forward, and when you're braking, same feeling about the braking, it is going back. Not so fast as I said, but it was still going back. So first of all, I was thinking that this is not so comfortable. I wanted to just remember for me that I need to say about this one. And in the first, when I see this, it was not about me, not about how I like to ride, but I ride more and I begin to realize that maybe this type of a solution is not bad, because when you're going forward, you need to push with all your legs, with all your body, with power parts, you're pushing this wheel forward. So your legs are when you're pushing, your legs going like that, and but the pedals are parallel to the ground. So and same is about the braking. When you're going back, the legs are going back like that, the wheels, the pedals still parallel. So what the Sherman do, Sherman little bit pushing the pedals, if you're braking or if you're accelerating, the pedals go with you. So I found after 10 kilometers I was done, I found that this is quite nice solution, but I want to say that this is nice solution only about if you're riding a lot with high speed, with long distances, where you don't need to make like a cornering, you know. For example, if we put this wheel for some type of a racetrack or for some type of competition, like the racing or on the racetrack, where you have a lot of corners but don't have a lot of room to speed up more. So idea is, but in my opinion, the wheel will not be so fast for you with the pedals. Just if you will push it, you're going, you need to brake, you start braking, the pedals go slowly back, but in this time you need to push it more, for example, to start after the corner, to start accelerating, so the pedals still down. So idea is, what I think, if you will need it, this performance, and in the short distances, I think the pedals will not be so fast to you, it will not react so fast. So and this may be annoying for you, and this will be not so comfortable. I think yes, but you need to test it more, of course, but seems this is a problem. Maybe in the future we will meet something like the sport mode, you know, you have the sport mode and the pedals are going deep faster, react faster for you. And for example, for the normal riding mode, how we have here now, it's quite, in my think, it is quite comfortable. Okay, this is about the foot plates, about the pedals, about the behavior of a wheel. Next part I want to talk with you about the motor here. So idea is that the overall acceleration and braking is very good for a such heavy wheel compared to AX. from the Godway, and for the Monster Pro, here we have better performance about how this wheel are feel for you when you're pushing it forward and back. It is feels more responsive, and this feels more lightweight. So about acceleration, the idea is what the I think this one Sherman are almost as fast as the Bugatti RS High Speed. I think as fast in acceleration here. It is not as fast as the torque version of the RS, but still I think just it is because of the weight of all wheel. So it is heavy weight, and I think what the power of a motor and how this power are provided by the main board, it is, in my feelings, from the 0 to for example 50, it is same like the RS HT version, but in the second point it is as fast as the RS. So here we clearly have a great new motor, which is quite torquey. And quite fast for you. So it is like the veteran Sherman taking both of this wheel and the torque and the speed. So yes, this motor is really good. I like this motor. Yes, I like it for sure. And another one very important point is about the bearings. This one motor using normal bearings type like all our previous generation wheels was, like the Nikola, like the 16X, like the MSP, like all in motion till the V11 and so on. So many users here know about it, but you will be able to go 10,000 kilometers with no problem with bearings, and you will definitely do not need to worry about if some type of dust and water will come inside and kill your bearing in next 300-500 kilometers here. So the power is great, the bearing is normal, and seems like all these new wheels from main manufacturers are coming to these hollow motors, and they still cannot solve completely the problem with rusty. And so for me, for sure, this product is really great for the users who want the ultimate machine. So nice, really nice from the Sherman. So we built a product which has a great power, great speed, huge battery packs, and this battery packs is 1865 650, so not 21700, so more parallels here and more safety for you. But one more moment I want to talk with you is, the wheel when I was start riding was about the 99 volts, not completely 100%, but still almost 100%. But I see when I was pushing sometime really fast this wheel, I was accelerating with all my 100 kilos weight really fast. So after I saw a log in the wheel log, so I saw what the voltage during this acceleration, the maximum between the phase, maximum power was about 20 kilowatts. And but another one important part and most important part is that the voltage was dropping from the 98 volts till the 88 volts, so 10 volts voltage drop on the acceleration on hard acceleration. So and I'm thinking if I would push it more, much more with all my power, with all my weight, I think I will cut it off. So, and this was 100%, almost 100% of the battery. So keep it in mind, so this motor is really powerful and the board can provide it. So we saw such solution in the, such, not solution, but such engineering we saw in the Kingsong 16X. So the motor is so powerful and the board can provide this power, but the batteries have their limits. So And here in the Sherman, I think we came to that limits with all these batteries, huge batteries, but huge power from the motor can give you some problems. If, for example, you have 50 or 40% of a battery and you will push like that this wheel, so the batteries will drop 10 more volts or maybe more than 10 volts. So it will be definitely cut off the moment, cut off for you. So just keep it in mind for the Sherman. Please ride little bit saver here, not just push it 100% all the time. You need to know this will have these limits. So this is very important part I wanted to share with you. So about the screen once more, so the screen idea of the screen is very good looking screen, and you see all these digits clearly, you see the speed, and I always wanted to see the speed. I know many riders are making here additional screen, buying for some types of small watches, Android watches, and putting the screens to see all these statistics. So here you don't need to do nothing. Great idea to have a screen, an informative screen here. I think the next level of a unicycles, maybe we will even put the projection screen, you know, just like the head up, and this projector will show you on the asphalt all needed statistics. For example, if you're going in the dark, you can see all the speed, all the statistics and voltage and power provided for you just in the front of a few meters in the front of you. This will be maybe next with technology, with a laser, or maybe with some type of projection screen. I hope someday we will see such solution. So, finally, why the Sherman are really come to the market with such a product, and really this company made this product really great, and many users, many users who ride extremely, this is the choice number one for all these users. Why? And I will try to answer to this question. First of all users, and here I will go back a little bit. So here we need to understand, we have some type of a split of a communities. Some type of a communities are advanced riders and beginners, and they don't need such a range, such a speed, such a performance. They don't going hardly off-road or in the forest and so on. They don't go 100 miles per day. So they just buying another type of products, much lighter wheels and more comfortable wheels like the V11 with a suspension and so on. And they are still happy about this wheel. They don't thinking about buying something like that. But it is another part of a community for extreme riders who like the speed, maximum speed, who like to experiment, who like this performance, jumping and so on. Really like to ride a lot with a friends, 100 miles plus per day and so on, and they need something ultimate on the market. And for the 2020, for the summer, the Sherman was the only one ultimate machine in this class. So not King Song, not in motion, not Gotway, we don't hear the clients and the clients need. So only one, the Sherman, the all new company here, all these clients, all these extreme sport clients here, and we made this product, we made Sherman, which have all this stuff. You have here this metals handles, and you can adjust any type of a tuning for lights and so on. This RAM system, you can extend all this stuff, put here a seat. So this is a room for you, like the SUV you have, Jeep. This is a room for you for the tuning and for your ideas. Many users just changing this one lamp, take it out, plug new lamps, putting it here on these rims, and you may have new lamps. So for the such solution, and we overall these metals, where this body is much more stronger compared to another products, and the speed is huge, the torque is huge, and the big tire, so it is 20 inch in overall dimension big tire, and we offered first factory which is offer the off-road tire from the box. And always solution like the screen and good handle in the middle and big mud guard. So all this stuff and huge battery, huge mileage you can go. So nobody from the all manufacturers cannot provide something like that. And overall, as I said, this wheel is not only good looking wheel, but it is great. This wheel have a great performance, in my opinion, really great performance for the extreme riders. It is number one now, and this with all this old technology bearings, it is number one for sure now. So we also all waited for the AX, for the AXN, we waited for Monster Pro, but Monster Pro, it is not like that. We cannot compare these two wheels, because Monster Pro, it is a wheel for the long rides, but not about the extreme and hard pushing, hard accelerating and hard braking. Yes, it is great product, but it is not so such a possibility for the Monster Pro to make it waterproof, like for example we have here so many solution made with all these holes in the Monster, keep it only in the dry surfaces. So here we have possibility to make it, to tune it till the waterproofness here. So I think that's the answer, because the manufacturers don't hear. So who hear the clients, who hear and speak with community, we made these updates and this situation is completely changes. So here, big plus for the Sherman team from and I think the next one generation of a Sherman will be great too, because I understand we know the direction, we know all this feeling, and we have a concept like how good extreme unicycle should look for the extreme community. That's it, I think. Thank you for watching. With Denis Hagov was here, use his shop. If you need some wheel, you just can contact us and we will send it to you in a few days. So thank you guys, bye bye.